Near the top now, the leader's picked a good route. He has kept in mind the job of getting down again easily and comfortably if the storm gets severe.
Bruce! Bruce, catch the hammer! Oh! Oh! Oh, you okay? Okay. Oh, hey guys! Just doing a bit of mountaineering, hang on.
And here's the top.
All right, before we get started, let's go ahead and go over our memory verse. Okay, here we go. You are of God, little children, and have overcome them. For he who is in you is greater than he that is in the world. 1 John 4:4. Great job. All right, now, if you're watching online with us, we only have one rule.
To kill fear, to use strength carefully, and to risk all for others.
To have fun. So, whenever we're singing and dancing, you gotta stand up and you gotta dance and sing with us. If we're playing a game, play the game with us, get involved. And you know what? Get everyone in your house that's watching with you, get them involved too. All right, well, it's time to play our first game. Here we go, it's game time.
Hey everybody, I'm Johnny Explosion, the world's greatest fitness and karate instructor. And this is my assistant, Janice.
Hey.
All right, we're gonna get started with a little bit of warm-up stretching. So let's go ahead and stretch out those arms.
Stretch out those arms.
There you go.
Nice and good.
Great job. All right, now we're gonna move to the neck. Yeah, take your neck and lean it to the left side. There we go. Stretch, stretch. Good, bring it back up to the top. We don't need the right side. And let's go into a nice warm-up jog. Nice warm-up jog just to get the blood flowing. Here we go.
I'm ready, Johnny.
All right, let's begin our first workout then. This workout is gonna be the Mega Jumping Jack. We're gonna put 10 seconds on the clock, and we're gonna see how many jumping jacks you can do.
Be careful.
Here we go. In 3, 2, 1. And stop. All right, Janice, how many did you do?
About 10.
10? Mm-hmm. That's a good number. Mm-hmm. How many did you do? I'm sure it was great. I did 127.
Wow.
But.
That's nice.
It's not the competition that matters. What matters is that you did it. But I did 127. All right, this next workout is gonna be our squat jumps. Here's how you do it. You're gonna get into a squat, just like this. And then you're gonna jump, explode up, and you're gonna reach for the stars and grab your dreams.
That's your dreams. Make it your prisoner.
Okay. Just catch your dreams. All right, here we go. 10 seconds on the clock. I wanna see how many jumping squats you can do. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Come on now. Leap to the heavens. Reach for God to give him a hug. Oh, yeah. And stop. All right, how many did you do, Janice?
I did.
And how many did you do at home? Great job. I did 386. New personal record. All right. Now it's time for the stretching. Janice.
You're gonna get
loosey-goosey.
Loosey-goosey. You know, really stretch those arms.
Oh, all right. All right.
Stretch those legs, Johnny. I wanna see you stretch them.
Okay, we're just gonna stretch out the legs.
Stretch the legs.
All right.
You can do better.
You follow along at home with the stretches.
Stretch!
Great job. All right, everybody. We've had so much fun. Now remember, eat your vitamins, say your prayers, and keep working out. We'll see you next time. Goodbye.
Is my pal Theodore.
Hello!
Today, our main point is God is my good and powerful Father. I think we should all say that together. What do you think, Theo?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Okay, I want everybody to stand up on your feet and we're gonna say this together. Ready? God is my good and powerful Father. Great job! All right, you can sit back down.
You know, Miss Haley,
what?
God is big and he's really strong, just like my dad. Because sometimes when I go camping, it can be a little bit scary.
Ooh,
and
yeah.
When it gets dark out, I know I don't have to worry because my big Papa Bear is there with me.
That's exactly right, Theo.
Yeah.
God is just like a powerful dad that protects us and takes such good care of us.
Oh, and even when something is scary, I can always trust my dad. Like this one time when he was trying to teach me to dive into the lake. And I was scared, but he put out his hand and he said he was watching. So I dove into the water because I knew he wouldn't let anything bad happen.
Oh, that's so good, Theo. We can trust in God just like we can trust in our earthly dads. He can be trusted and he always keeps his promises.
Yeah, God is so good. He's the best and he's the strongest. Just like my dad is really strong and he can lift a whole tree out of the ground to help me get some yummy honey.
That's right. God is so big and powerful. That's why our main point says that God is our good and powerful Father.
Yeah, he's awesome.
He's the best. You know what? I think we should say our main point one more time just to make sure that everybody watching knows that God is their good and powerful Father.
Yeah.
Okay, I want everybody to stand up on your feet one more time and we're gonna say it together, but this time I want you to say it so loud that everybody in your house can hear it, okay? Ready? 1, 2, 3. God is our good and powerful Father. That was so great, good job.
Did somebody say power? How would you like to have so much power that you explode? We're talking about gratuitous amounts of power with God's power. It's God's power in a can. Boom, shotgun arms. We've taken God's word and turned it into a liquid for you to put in your body. Now made with caffeine. God's power plus energy. How would you like to have the super strength of Samson? Then try our latest flavor, Hamson, made with real ham. Tear lions in half and bring down buildings with a single punch. God's power. 16 ounces of holy exasperation. Drink God's power and you'll be good at everything forever. Sports, swimming, praying, singing, baking, karate, sailing, gold. You'll have streets made of gold. Turn water into awesome. Are there boys at school calling you names? No one will call you names wherever you can walk on water. Though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you will crush all evil with your power fist. Oh! Flavors include Disciple of Christ, Lamentations, and Sin No More with the great taste of cinnamon. Do you want to be wise? Do you like the Book of Proverbs plus the flavor of strawberry? Then try Strawberbs. You'll be so smart, you'll make scientists look like little babies. Are you a baby? No! Then get God's power and put it in your body today.
Only $6.99 plus shipping.
Oh yeah, God's power! I am the ultimate being because God's power is within me!
Hey Buttons, what are you up to?
Just being awesome. I have God's power. Oh yeah, look at these muscles. Oh yeah, prepare to be smote!
Oh, did you have some of that energy drink?
Oh yeah. I have God's power. Oh yeah, $6.99 plus shipping, totally worth it.
Buttons, that is not actually God's power. It's just caffeine and sugar, which is probably why you're so hyper.
Really, but I thought God was my good and powerful father. I thought that his power was in me.
He is, but it doesn't work like that. It's not
anything. How does it work?
I was actually about to read a Bible story with the kids. Do you want to read it with us?
Yeah.
A long time ago,
yeah,
in a land called Egypt, there was a new king called Pharaoh. God's people, the Israelites, were living in Egypt, and Pharaoh hated them. He made them into his slaves and beat them and made them work really hard. They didn't have any days off.
So this Pharaoh guy was making them do all of his chores, and they didn't even get to have fun and play sports or play video games.
Nope. But the most horrible thing that Pharaoh did is when he saw how many Israelites there were, he ordered that some of the Israelite boys be thrown into the Nile River and killed.
What? That's evil. He can't do that. Oh, let me at him. Oh, I'm ready for battle. Prepare to be smoked, Pharaoh!
Buttons, hang on. Something was gonna happen. The Israelites are God's people, remember? They cried out to him and he heard them and remembered that he promised he would always take care of them. He was gonna find a way to set them free.
Like I said, prepare to be smoked, Pharaoh!
One day, an Israelite woman who didn't want her baby to get hurt put him inside a basket in the river. That baby's name was Moses.
Moses.
But the Egyptian princess found the basket and saw that Moses was so cute. So she decided to keep him. And guess who she got to help take care of him?
Who?
Moses' mom.
Oh, that's so nice.
So Moses grew up in the palace like an Egyptian, but he always knew that he was an Israelite. When Moses became a man, he left the palace and visited his people, where he saw them being forced to work really hard, and an Egyptian guard was beating one of them. After seeing this, Moses waited until he saw no one was looking and killed the Egyptian. But the next day, people knew what Moses had done.
Oh no!
And Pharaoh tried to have Moses killed. So he ran away to a place called Midian.
I thought you said that God had a plan to help Miss Victoria. This story's full of chaos!
Okay, hang on. I'm getting there. While Moses was in Midian taking care of his sheep, he saw something that caught his eye.
Hmm?
A bush behaving very oddly.
What was it doing?
It was on fire, but the leaves weren't burning up.
Oh,
he took a closer look. Moses, boomed a loud voice. Moses leapt back. The bush was talking to him.
It's God's power!
I have heard my people's cries, God said. I have seen their tears, so I have come to rescue them. Go to Pharaoh and tell him to let my people go. Moses was afraid, but God said, I will be with you. So Moses went back to Pharaoh
and released an onslaught of God's power and wrath.
No,
incoming!
There weren't even guns back then. Went to Pharaoh. Pharaoh, Moses began. God said, let his people go.
Yeah.
God, laughed Pharaoh. Never heard of him. Why should I obey him? I don't want to. I won't.
Wrong answer, Buster. Hold your fire and wait for my signal.
Who are you talking to?
The armies of the heavens.
Hold on, Buttons. Even though Pharaoh was evil, God still gave him a chance. He started with a warning called a plague. He turned the River Nile into blood.
Are you serious? This story is awesome! Yeah! Come on, God's power!
No one could drink the water anymore, but Pharaoh still would not let the Israelites go. So God sent even more plagues, an attack of frogs and gnats and flies. And still, Pharaoh kept saying no. Then a disease on every animal, sores on people's skin, hail falling from the sky. But Pharaoh would not listen.
Are you serious? Where did Egypt find this guy? Is there a judicial system, checks and balances? This sounds like your classic abuse of power.
Then came locusts and utter darkness. The sun didn't shine for 3 days straight, but Pharaoh stayed so stubborn through all of it and refused to let the Israelites go.
Come on, Pharaoh.
So God sent one final plague, the death of every firstborn son in Egypt. And this was God's act of judgment against Pharaoh for killing all the Israelite boys in the river.
Oh, man. Please tell me that Pharaoh listened to God this time.
He did. Get out, he said. Just go, take whatever you want, and take your God with you. And so that very same night, Moses and all the Israelites gathered their things and left Egypt as free men and women of God. God had rescued them from slavery.
Yay, God's power is so awesome. Oh yeah.
But then...
Oh no, don't tell me that Pharaoh changed his mind.
He did.
Oh, come on!
When the Israelites had come to the Red Sea and made camp, Pharaoh and his entire army could be seen chasing after them. It would take forever to go around the sea. They were trapped. But Moses reassured the people, don't be afraid. God will save you. He will fight for you.
Oh yeah, it's time for the army of heaven to descend down on the Egyptians. Prepare to be smoked!
Moses, God said, lift up your staff and stretch out your hand over the waters. And suddenly, before the eyes of all the Israelites, the water split in two. Moses and everyone else was able to walk through the sea on foot.
But Miss Victoria, what about the Egyptians? Because they're right behind them.
God told Moses to stretch out his hand once again, and the waters crashed over the Egyptians. The Bible says not one of them escaped.
Justice!
God's people would always remember this great rescue. God is our good and powerful Father, and nothing and no one will ever keep him from us. He always makes a way, he always keeps his promises, and he moves heaven and earth to be with us.
Wow, what an amazing story. So that's what God's power is like.
Remember our memory verse buttons. You are of God, little children, and have overcome them, for he who is in you is greater than he who is in the world. We don't need a can of God's power, because God's power is in us. We are God's children, and he is always going to take care of us.
Well, that makes sense, but this stuff is still pretty tasty. Have you tried their new flavor for Punch of the Spirit?
Mm-mm.
Here, try some.
Okay. Whoa.
Savory.
That is really good.
Yeah.
Whew. I feel like I could run a marathon or do a really, really big puzzle.
Oh, see, I told you. Hey, I'll raise you.
That sounds like a challenge.
It is.
All right, everybody, we gotta go.
All right. Well, see. Hey, wait, that's not fair. You go ahead, start. Hang on.
Hey guys, it's Matt. I have a question for you. It's really important. Super duper important. Okay, so I want you to answer as honestly as you can. All right. How many of you like ice cream? I love ice cream. Ice cream is awesome. I like dark chocolate chip cookie dough, cookies and cream. I really like chocolate. And then I like strawberry and vanilla. They're all awesome. In fact, when I eat ice cream, I have a super special spoon that I eat my ice cream with. Look at this. Looks like an ordinary spoon, but let's say you want to try some of your friend's ice cream across the table. Ha ha! And then you take some of the ice cream. I don't know what happened, Billy. Ice cream's gone missing. It's awesome. I love this spoon, and I love ice cream. Now, why do we all love ice cream so much? Well, because it's good. I mean, there's nothing bad about ice cream. It's super good. And God is the same way. I mean, not like we put sprinkles on God and eat him, because that would be weird. But God is so good, we can't measure how good he is. In fact, we've been learning about how God made all of us. He made everything. He is our Father. And our main point is, God is my good and powerful Father. So everybody stand up. We're going to say that together. Say it after me. Ready? Say, God is my good and powerful Father. Great job. You guys can take a seat. So God is our good and powerful Father. Well, what does that mean? Well, it's like I said earlier, God created all of us. He created you, he created me, every single one of us. We're all his kids. And it's not just that, God, he wants to be close with all of us. He wants to be close with you. Think about it like this. Let's say you had a bowl of ice cream and you had this bowl of ice cream. And then after that, you were like, you know what? I don't think I need to have ice cream ever again. I've had ice cream and that's enough for me, never again. I mean, that's insane, right? There's so many different flavors of ice cream. You want to keep eating ice cream. I mean, not all in one sitting, but you want to keep having ice cream, right? There's all these different flavors and toppings and all these different combinations that you can have. Well, God is the same way. God is so good that the closer we get with him, more of a relationship that we have with him, the more we discover about his goodness. See, if this small little bowl of ice cream is good, then God would be like, whoa, look at this. Have you ever seen this much ice cream before? It's incredible. It would take forever to eat this thing. See, there's so much good in God that there's no room for bad. There's no room for evil. See, he created everything for us and he provides for us. In fact, in the Bible, in James 1:17, it says, every good thing and every perfect gift is from God. These gifts come down from the creator of the sun, the moon, and the stars. God does not change like shifting shadows. See, God is good, and that's never gonna change. And he's the most perfect father you can ever imagine. See, sometimes we have really good fathers here on earth that still make decisions that aren't right. And then sometimes we have bad fathers that make decisions that hurt us. And if you're like me, You might not have a father, but the amazing thing is that no matter what father you may or may not have here on earth, you have an all-powerful, all-knowing, loving Father in heaven who is willing to do anything for you. Your Father spoke everything into existence. Think about that. Your dad, the same God that lives in me, that lives in you, he spoke and he made light. But what's amazing is his goodness doesn't stop there. See, God is our protector and he covers us. I love chocolate syrup. Do you guys like chocolate syrup? Let's put some more on there. He covers us and he protects us from all sorts of things. That's looking really good. There we go. In the Bible, in the book of Psalm 46:1, it says, God is our protection and our strength. He always helps us in times of trouble. So we will not be afraid when the earth shakes or if the mountains fall into the sea. I mean, the earth shaking, the mountains falling into the sea, that's pretty dramatic, isn't it? But God is always there with us. Nothing can get through him when he is standing in front of you. And see, sometimes in our lives, there can be times where we can get really afraid. We can be really scared. We can feel the spirit of fear trying to attack us. But when that happens, all you have to do is remember that the God that created the universe is inside of you. And where he is, fear cannot be. So you can just say, fear, you cannot be here because God is in me. Who likes sprinkles? I love sprinkles. Let's put some on here. It's gonna be like a rainbow. There we go. There we go. Perfect. Is that good? No, I think we need some more. See, God is our provider. He loves providing for his kids. There we go. In the Bible, in John 15:7, it says, if you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask whatever you wish and it will be done for you. See, there have been so many times in my life where I've felt like I'm not getting what everyone else is getting or I'm missing out on something. There's this thing that I don't have in my life. But I've seen time and time again where God has come in and he has performed a miracle and I've gotten either what I was missing or the thing that actually I needed. See, we always don't know what we need. But God does. He knows exactly what you need, when you need it, and his time is always perfect. All you have to do is ask God for him to give you what you need in his perfect timing, and he'll help you. But it doesn't stop there. I have gummy bears. Who likes gummy bears? Oh, each one of these is a treasure. It's so good. Let's put some gummy bears on here. That's great. A little bit more. See, we can always trust God. We can always trust that he is gonna keep his promises to us. See, God, he can't lie. It's absolutely impossible. See, in the Bible, in Numbers 23:19, it says, God is not human, so he cannot lie. He does not change his mind. And it doesn't stop there either. I have whipped cream. Do you guys like whipped cream? Oh my goodness. Hang on. That's some good stuff. Let's put some whipped cream on here. That's good. Put some more here and there. You know what? Let's just put it all over. There. God has, oh no! We're gonna have to fill it back in. There we go. God has a perfect plan for you. In fact, in the Bible, in Jeremiah 29:11, it says, I know the plans I have for you. I don't plan to hurt you. I plan to give you hope and a good future. See, God's plans for you, they're perfect. Everything about you that he has planned for you is amazing. Think of it like this. Have you ever seen a parade before? See, when you're standing on the side of the street watching the parade go by, you can only see about one or two floats at a time. They're coming by and you see I don't know, you see a TV character and then you see another one and then, oh, here comes another one, but you're waiting for your favorite one to come and then you have to wait there on the side of the road. Yeah, like that's what you see in a parade. But imagine being up in a helicopter really high up in the air and you can look down and you can see every bit of the parade all the way through the streets. You can see every single detail of it. That's the way God sees your life. He knows every single choice. He knows every single event. He knows everything that's gonna happen. And so he has the perfect plan for you. We can always trust that his plan is good. And last, I think it's time to put some cherries on top. How many of you like cherries? I love cherries. These are good in ice cream. They're good in everything, really. I mean, you can't put cherries on something and it's not delicious. Cherries are the best. See, God promises all of this for us. And he even made a way for us to be with him and receive all of these promises. That was his ultimate act of goodness, was he made a way for all of this, all of the good things about him to be ours, for all of those promises to be ours. So remember, God made you. You're his child, and he loves you so, so much. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna have a cherry, and I'm gonna eat some of this ice cream. I'll see you guys later.
Wasn't that so much fun?
Oh yeah, I sure love ice cream. I already ate all of mine though.
Yeah. I love ice cream too. I think we should all say our memory verse together. What do you think, Theo?
Oh yeah.
Okay, everybody stand up and we're gonna say it together. Ready? You are of God, little children, and have overcome them. For he that is in you is greater than he that is in the world. 1 John 4:4. Great job. You can have a seat. Oh, I just love that God is our good and powerful Father.
Yeah, and he loves you so much.
That's right, Theo. He does love us so much. Well, friends, I think we are about out of time, but the fun doesn't have to end. If you click the link below, you'll find a link to an activity page, a craft video, and some fun worship songs so that you can praise Jesus all day long.
Yay.
We can't wait to see you next time. Bye.
Bye.